Okay, then fine, I'm going to start now. So get ready. The first question is in front of you. Which change is an oxidation? FeO2, Fe2O3, Fe2O3 to FeO, H2O2 to H2O, and H2O to H2. Which change is oxidation? Okay, 70 students have already answered,
Yes,
so you need to
Vayu.
do it fast, but it's not at the cost of wrong answer. Right, correct answer only. Yes, I think who has not answered? Answer it. Ankur sir, have you answered? Okay, fine. So most of you have given the right answer. It's the first option, A only. So because if you see, okay, the answer is Fe2O3 only. So how to check? FeO, you got FeO and it was forming Fe2O3. So one, if you go with the oxygen, one iron is having one oxygen. Okay, now one iron is having 1.5 oxygen. You can go like that also. Otherwise, the best method, it is minus 2 plus 2. Okay, it is plus 3 minus 2. Change in oxidation number is for increase in oxidation number is increase in oxidation number. Increase in oxidation number. Okay, so next question. So Meghna is leading now. Let's have the second question. Which statement describes what happened in the reaction shown? Carbon and magnesium both are oxidized. Carbon is oxidized and magnesium oxide is reduced. Magnesium is oxidized and carbon dioxide is reduced. Magnesium oxide and carbon dioxide are both reduced. Ankur sir, have you answered? Okay, still three are wrong. Still 8, 9, 10 students are wrong. Okay, so answer is very easy for this question. If you see the, okay, first see the leaderboard. Hi, Anushka is leading now. Oh, Surya P, very good. Aslesa was the fastest to answer this. Okay, to explain this, you have MgO and you got the CO2 reacted with it. So what will happen? Magnesium, 1 minute. But you did we have magnesium or magnesium oxide? I think magnesium is there, no? So it will give you MgO, magnesium is getting oxidized and carbon is getting reduced. Yes? Mg plus CO2. Mg plus CO2, yes. MgO and so it is oxidized and it is reduced. Okay. So now next question. So one is oxidized means other is definitely getting reduced. You can go with the oxidation number as well. So in which state case oxidation is taking place? Okay, Neha, now you can't join because the quiz has already started. Once it gets started, you can't join. Okay, I've already joined, then it's fine.
No, anytime anyone
So
can
like that,
join
fine.
as of now. We have not kept the window logged. So when you
Okay.
enter the code, they can join.
Okay, sir, okay. Okay. Okay, one more student. Okay, 70. Now it has increased. Okay, so so 49 are right, but still 23, 4 and 4. So there are many of you have answered it wrong. So let me tell you the answer. Answer was the D option. Now what was the question? The question was very easy to see. The question is saying that which among the elements of vanadium, which is oxidation taking place? Question was given VO2 is converting into V2O3. Okay, and next option was V2O5 converting into VO2. Why you people have made mistake in this? V2O3 is converting into VO. And the last option was V2O3 converts into V2O5. Okay, see the oxidation number. If you see the oxidation numbers, it is like this. Oxygen is minus 2. Yes, so plus 4 and minus 2. What else? Now here it is minus 2. Oxygen is minus 2. So accordingly to balance that, it is plus 3. So it is reduction. Vanadium is going from plus 4 to plus 3. It is reduction. Okay, similarly you do for this. It is plus 5 oxidation number. It is plus 4. Again reduction. If anyone is facing any issue, please let me know. Oxygen is now here. If you do the crisscross, it is plus 3 and it is plus 2. Here also, if you do crisscross, plus 3. Here it is plus 5. The only option where oxidation number increases is this. It is oxidation. I hope you got the answer. Okay, next. Any doubt? Okay, don't write yes. If anyone has any doubt, just write something or N, something like that. Okay, fine. Next question. Next question. Which of this reaction lead oxide is oxidized? Try to give right answer. We have discussed this question, so don't make a single mistake. Okay, still seven students have made the mistake. Fine. The question was very easy. Okay, first see the leaderboard. Leaderboard says that Surya P is still leading and fastest was Sanjeev. Good. So again, it was just the question related to the lead oxide. In all the three cases, lead oxides was converting into lead. You can directly say. In all the three cases, A, B, C, it was converting into lead. But in the last option, it was going to PbO2. D option. So if you see here, it is plus 2, minus 2, 0. So plus 2, lead is going from plus 2 to 0. Reduce in oxidation number is reduction. And here it is 0 to, here it is plus 2 to plus 4. So it is oxidation. It's oxidation. Okay. Next. The red color is some pottery glazes may be formed as a result of the reaction shown. CuCO3, CuCO2 and CO2, and further CuO reacts with SnO2. This equation shows is oxidized and 2 is reduced. Which substance correctly complete the gas completes the gaps 1 and 2 in the above reaction? So 55 I have already answered. Fine. Oh, mixed answers. Fine. So answer is D only. Now let's have a discussion on this. One is oxidized and other is getting reduced. So see, in last class I also told you. Now see, many of you may get confused with the first reaction, that was CuCO3 converting into CuO plus CO2. You know, in this reaction, if you say which is oxidation, which is reduction, if you got confused, I also don't know what will happen. So what I will do, I will see the oxidation number. So what, how to see the oxidation number? You know that copper sulfate is formed by, copper carbonate is formed by Cu2 plus and CO3 2 minus by crisscross. Definitely it is plus 2. Now, carbonate is CO3 2 minus. I don't know about carbon. I consider it as a X. So I don't know oxidation number of carbon. I have considered it as X. Oxygen is nothing but minus 2. So how to calculate the X? I know the overall compound is neutral. If it is overall neutral, means net charge is 0. Net charge is 0. If net charge is 0, I can write 2 times plus X minus 2 into 3, because 3 oxygen atoms are there. So this is 0, implies X is nothing but plus 4. X is plus 4. Once you get X is plus 4, means I will write here it is plus 4. Now, if you see copper, it is still plus 2, minus 2. Okay, do here, oxygen is minus 2. So there are 2 oxygen minus 4. This carbon must be plus 4. This carbon must be plus 4. Add an electron. Okay. So, now, So this is actually, there is no redox reaction in this. Copper retains its oxidation number. Every atom retains its oxidation number. So no change in oxidation number. So it is not a redox reaction. Okay. So this means that everything is there in the next reaction only. What was the next reaction? For next reaction was CuO converting into, reacting with SnO. Converting into Cu plus SnO2. So if you go with the oxygen transfer, you can directly say which is oxidized, which is reduced. If you want to go with the redox oxidation number, plus 2, minus 2, plus 2, minus 2, 0. Neutral atom is, element is always having 0 oxidation number. Plus 4, minus 2. So SN is going from plus 2 to plus 4. This is oxidation. Copper is going from plus 2 to 0. Reduce in oxidation number. So copper is going from plus 2 to 0. It is reduction. So this is the answer. Last option was SNO is oxidized. Yes, SNO is oxidized. Okay, next question. Okay, Aniket came fastest, very good. Okay, but still you have to think, you should don't make mistake. Take your time and write the correct option. Just a minute. How it got? Repeated. Okay, I think it's a repetition of question. Okay, just mark the correct answer. We have already done this, but no problem. Mark the correct option. Oh, sorry. Option is given. Hydrogen is not a metal, but it has been included in the reactivity series because it. The photo is wrong. Don't see the photo. Question is, hydrogen is not a metal, but it has been included in the reactivity series because it. Look at the options. Hydrogen is not a metal, but it has been included in the reactivity series because it. Pick is wrong, but just see the options. Yes, what you learned from this question, those who have answered just without seeing because they want to answer it fast, you should read the options also. I think options are visible to you. Okay, 52 of you are right. Only 18 students mark it wrong because they have not read options properly. Maybe some of. Okay, so answer is A. Because hydrogen is also showing a character like a metal, it loses electron. Like metal loses electron, how? If I take sodium. Sodium lose electron like Na+. It form Na++ plus E. Similarly, hydrogen says. Okay, hydrogen takes the same thing, H plus plus E. So hydrogen forms H, okay, though it's it forms by H2 only, 2H plus plus 2E, but it shows the, that's why it resembles the alkali metal. Okay. So read the question properly. Okay, now next question. So next question is in front of you. Reactivity of iron, magnesium, sodium, zinc towards water are in the following order. Select the correct answer. Reactivity of iron, magnesium, sodium and zinc towards water in the following order. Three of you have not answered. Answer it fast. Okay, take your time, but don't make wrong mistake. Okay, 51 of you have answered, 58 of you have answered, right? Good. So there is a one, you know, there is a reactivity series, and I generally tell one trick to students. Those who don't know, they can remember the trick for the reactivity series. What is that? Please stop calling me. Stop calling me a careless. A careless, yes, zombie. Instead, try learning how Creator's mercy saves green planet. Saves green planet. Okay, so what is please? P for please is potassium. K. Stop is sodium. Calling is calcium. Okay. So stop calling me is magnesium. A is aluminium. Careless is carbon. Remember, this is a non-metal I have added here. Okay. Zombie is zinc. Instead is iron. Try is tin. Try is tin. Learning is lead. How is hydrogen? It is also non-metal. Creators is copper. Mercy is Hg. Saves is silver. Green is gold. Planet is platinum. Okay. So this is a trick you can remember. Okay, those who are wondering why sir has added carbon and hydrogen in this. Because if you see, carbon can reduce all of these. Carbon can't reduce all of these. That's why in extraction of a metal from its ore, we don't use carbon for these metals. We can use carbon for these metals, for extraction of, or for reduction. So what can I say? Carbon cannot reduce all these. Carbon cannot reduce. So this group carbon cannot reduce. That's why I have added carbon in this series. Okay. So, and you know that reactive metal displaces less reactive metal from its salt. So if you have a zinc oxide plus carbon, you can easily get zinc plus CO. But when you have a Al2O3 plus carbon, you won't get aluminium plus CO. Okay. So that's the reason. And this is in front of you. It is very important series. Okay, thank you. So yes, Anike, tell me what. Anike, do you want to say something? Okay, fine. So this will help you a lot. That's why I have told you, my student. Okay, fine. So next question. Yes, now enter this. Take some time. Don't answer it so fast. I can't see question. Question is, which of the following nitrogen oxides is an anhydride of HNO2? Which of the following nitrogen oxides is an anhydride of HNO2? Question is, and options N2O, NO2, N2O3 and N2O5. Options are in the questions itself. You can see options are in the question. Okay, so answer is, oh my god, answer was C and U. Okay, fine. So just see the question. The question was very easy. HNO2, not very easy, but still it's a good question. HNO2, they have asked the anhydride. Anhydride means when you remove water from something, you will get the anhydride. Okay. Then someone say, okay sir, how to remove water? It has only one hydrogen. If you want to remove water, you have to subtract H2O, but it has only one water. Fine, take two molecules of HNO2 and HNO2. Take two molecules. If you remove water from this, what you are going to get? Remove water means 2H you will remove, nitrogen R2 and 2O3. This is an anhydride. Is it clear to all of you? Yes. What is the anhydride of, let's say, HNO3? What is the anhydride of HNO3? What is anhydride of HNO3? Very good. So you can do like that. Understood? It is to take two molecules of this and subtract water, it will form N2O5. Okay, fine. Next question. Which of the following is true? Okay, don't see the image, just see the option. Just see the options and question. Which of the following is true? Don't see the image. Which of the following option is true? Color of basic copper carbonate is green. Malachite is an ore of copper. Aluminium is more reactive than copper. All of above. Don't see image, just write, see the options and select the best option. No option again. Why option? I told you, copper is color of basic copper carbonate is green. Malachite ore is copper. Aluminium is more reactive than copper. Why you have done that when I told 2-3 times? Why you have answered for the pick if I told you to go for the option? Which of the following is okay? So answer, most of you have given the 39. Okay, the question was, all the options were correct. Okay, malachite is a ore of copper. Basic copper carbonate is green in color. So all the options were correct. Okay. Yes. It's taking random options. So just refreshing will maybe okay, you can refresh it and join it, I think. Okay, don't refresh. Okay, next question, I'm showing it to you. Okay, it will not let you join again. So don't refresh it. Okay, it's a mixed opinion. So you can refresh it, I think. You can refresh it. Okay, refresh it and join. So all the three options were right in the previous question. Okay, next question. Okay, please ignore. Oh shit, it got submitted by itself. Okay, sorry, it got submitted by itself. Sorry for that.
Sir, I'm seeing only terms and conditions, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not able to.
Terms and conditions?
After the question. Nothing. It's just.
Are you not able to see the question?
Then, Aditya.
What's your
Aditya.
Name?
Aditya.
Huh? Aditya.
No, Aditya. NPS
Aditya. Okay, just a minute.
Aditya, you just need to kill that browser. Go to a new browser. Type menti.com and type the code. You will be able to log in.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, Prabhat sir, carry on please.
Sir, just a minute. Okay, the question I'm reading in front of you, there is some problem in this, but what is the question? Which of the following method is suitable for preventing iron frying pan from rusting? So you apply the zinc coating in that. Okay, applying paint will not work and applying grease will not work. You have a zinc coating so that you can prevent it from the rusting. Okay, this is the question, but we are moving to the next question. Just a minute, guys. Let me see. Okay. Krishan, I am reading in front of you. Which of the following metal will not displace hydrogen from steam? Dilute acid and alkalis. Iron, zinc, mercury and calcium. Okay, we don't use paint because there are chemicals. When you heat that, they may the things may be volatile in nature. So that is not good for and it will mix with the food which we eat. That's why we don't put paint. Okay, please don't chat. If you have anything related to question, then only you can talk. Which of the following, see now, the question was which of the following will not displace hydrogen from steam? Dilute acid and alkalis. Hydrogen from steam, dilute acid and alkalis. So see, okay. Zinc will displace, most of you have written the mercury as an answer. Zinc is more reactive than hydrogen. Yes, zinc is not the answer at all. Okay, so, but which will not displace hydrogen from steam and alkalis? So, alkali, you know, just a minute. Okay, we'll come to this question again. I think answer put is wrong here. So we'll come to this question again. Okay, move to the next one. We'll discuss this. Okay. Leave this question. Okay, so next question. Please solve this question. Okay, so see, most of you have made mistake in this question. The question was in the double displacement reaction between potassium iodide, this is Ki, which is going to react with aqueous lead nitrate. Aqueous lead nitrate is PbNO3 whole twice. Okay, it will give you the yellow precipitate, Yes, definitely it will give you yellow precipitate, that is PbI2, it is yellow in color. Okay, so, and lead iodide, the PbI2, that is yellow in color. While performing this activity, lead nitrate is not available. Which of the following can be used as a lead nitrate? Now see, here you have the option called as lead acetate. You know, you have to select that one, which is, this is aqueous, this is soluble salt. This is soluble salt. Okay, you have to select the soluble salt, and this is also soluble. This is a kind of precipitation reaction, it is a precipitate. So you need to take the soluble salt. If you take PbSO4, it is again a precipitate, white precipitate. You can't take this. Lead acetate, yes, lead acetate will work. CH3COO-. Lead acetate will work. Ammonium nitrate. Ammonium nitrate will not give you PbI2 at all. You need lead in that. So only option left is B only. Okay. So B is the correct answer. Any doubt? Because you need to make PbI2. So what will be the reaction here? If I write the reaction with lead acetate, Ki plus Pb CH3 whole twice, this is lead acetate. PbCH3 whole twice. So what it will form? It will again form PbI2 only. Multiply it with 2 plus it will form the acetate with potassium. So you can write KCH3CO. Though it is an ionic compound, CH3CO minus and K plus will form. Is it clear? So PbI2 you need to make the yellow compound. Next question. Okay, question read is, which of the following gases can be used to store a fresh sample of an oil for a long time? Okay, yes, don't see the picture, just read the option, just read the question, don't see the picture. Which of the following gases can be used for the storage of fresh sample of an oil for a long time? And read the options. Okay, so helium and nitrogen is the correct option. Because you want to store something, so you need a gas which is very less reactive. So very less reactive, nitrogen is very less reactive because of, actually nitrogen is very very less reactive because of triple bond present in nitrogen. And helium is very less reactive because it is a noble gas. It is a noble gas. So you can use this for preservation of something. So I hope you got the answer. And all other are reactive. Carbon dioxide is reactive. Carbon dioxide or oxygen. Nitrogen and oxygen. Nitrogen is fine, but oxygen is reactive. Carbon dioxide or helium. Carbon dioxide is reactive. So only option left is D. Okay, next question. Okay, who is M? Okay, I'm Monish. Any doubt in this question? No doubt? Okay, next question. The following reaction is used for the preparation of oxygen gas in presence of catalyst in a laboratory. Which of the following statement is are correct about the reaction? It is a decomposition reaction and endothermic in nature. It is a combination reaction. It is a decomposition reaction and accompanied by release of heat. It is a photochemical decomposition reaction and exothermic in nature. Aniket, please, because it's happening with you. Is it happening with others also? Other than Aniket? Surya also. Okay, fine. Okay. Pratiksha, Anirudh, it's happening with you. Maybe you are in hurry to answer and by mistake it got clicked. Ah, it's a very less chance, but still it will not happen again and again. So maybe some issue is there. Okay, so see, the question is very clear why you people have made mistake in this. The question is very clear that KClO3 is reacting, yes, and KClO3 on reaction, and it is like it is solid and you are heating it. So first of all, it is endothermic only. When you heat something, it is endothermic, okay, and you are getting 2 KCl plus 3O2 gas. Okay, so it is a kind of, okay, if you see, it is a kind of decomposition reaction. Decomposition means one compound breaks into two or more. So it is a decomposition. So what I will write? Decomposition. Decomposition reaction. And what else? It is a endothermic. Endothermic. Clear? Should we move to next question? Okay, next. Which of the following process involve chemical reaction? Which of the following process involve chemical reactions? Storing of oxygen gas under pressure in a gas cylinder, liquefaction of air, keeping petrol in china dish in an open container, heating copper wire in presence of air at high temperature. Okay, most of you have answered it right, but why you people have made mistake in this? Okay, so let's discuss the two questions which are left. So which of the following reactions? Storing a oxygen gas in a cylinder under a pressure. You know, chemical change we only say when there is a, when we say chemical change, when there is some new compound is forming and old compound is breaking down. Then we say there is a chemical reaction. When you put oxygen and you condense it, you will, let's say, liquid oxygen you get, but there is no change in compound. Similarly, liquefaction of air, same thing. Okay, keeping petrol in China dish. If you put petrol, it will evaporate. It will evaporate, but still it's a wet petroleum vapors. So it is not a chemical reaction. The option D is the only correct thing, where copper wire reacts with air. Copper wire, when reacts with air, let's say it will form a copper oxide. So it is a chemical reaction. Okay, at high temperature it will form copper oxide. Now there is a one question which I told you, we will see it again. That question I am reading it and it was correct. Those who have given mercury as an answer, it is correct only. Let's see what was the question. Which of the following metal will not displace hydrogen? That question was right. Which of the following will not displace hydrogen from steam? From steam, dilute acid and alkalis. I thought they are asking for a single thing, they are asking for all the three things. Like, if any metal gives hydrogen with any of these, then that will be not our answer. Let's talk about iron. Iron will give hydrogen with this, with dilute acid it will give, with alkalis it will not give. So if with any of this, if it gives hydrogen, that is not our answer. So if I say, is it my answer? No, it is not my answer. Let's talk about other. Zinc. Zinc with steam, it will give hydrogen. Dilute acid will give. Even with alkalis, it give. It will form Na2ZnO2. Na2ZnO2, this time I think you got this question in exam also. With hydrogen gas, liberated. So this is also not our answer. Now it's a mercury, a very less reactive element. As we discussed in the series, where is the mercury in the series? Here, saves green planet. It is below hydrogen. So mercury is our answer because it will not give hydrogen with steam also, will not give with dilute acid also, will not give with alkali. So this is our answer. Let's take a last option, that is calcium. With steam, it will give hydrogen. With dilute acid, it will give hydrogen. With alkalis, it will not give hydrogen. Okay, so this is not our answer. So most least reactive atom is our answer for this question. Anyone has any doubt, please let me know. Otherwise, I will ask one question related to this. Any doubt? No. Okay, what all metals will give hydrogen with alkalis? Quickly tell me the answer. What all metals will give hydrogen with alkalis? What all metals will release hydrogen with alkalis? Tell me. Sodium will not give. Those who have written sodium, it's wrong. Okay, aluminium, zinc and calcium and magnesium will not give. Alisha. Okay, for your syllabus, for your knowledge, you can remember the three metals. There are many. But for you, you can remember zinc, Pb, aluminium. These three metals will give hydrogen with alkalis also. What will be the reaction I am writing in front of you? Zinc plus NaOH. All will form some common type of formula. What? Like ZnO2 you will get here. With Pb and NaOH, you will get the same type of formula. What? PbO2. With aluminium and NaOH, you will get the same kind of formula. AlO2. But number of sodium will get differ. It is Na2ZnO2, it is Na2PbO2, but it is NaAlO2. This is the formula along with you will get hydrogen gas. Here in case of aluminium, you have to add water also, otherwise you will not able to balance the reaction. Here you have to add the water. So these three reactions are very, very important. So these three are known as amphoteric metals. What we call them? Amphoteric metals. Amphoteric metals are those metals which liberates hydrogen with hydrogen with alkalis also. These three are in your syllabus. If you want to know more metals, there is tin also, Be also, chromium also, gallium also. Fine. So these are also are amphoteric in nature, but for you it is three are important. I hope you got the concept behind this question. So questions were all right. There was one issue with the few systems, like you are saying that it is taking questions by its own. So we'll see this issue and we'll try that this won't happen from the next class. Any other doubt? Do you have any other doubt? No? Okay. So just see the final result for today's class. Oh, good. Shreyas. Very good, Shreyas. Shreyas S. Congratulations. Okay. So, hope you learned something and you have understood the concept of amphoteric metals and a reactivity series, which you can use till class 12th also. It will be helpful for you. Okay. That's all for today. Okay. Thank you.